Okay, and here is this my cars, this engine computer unit, and there is this product number. Remember to check that you have when you are planning to replace that unit, that you have same numbers, and then remember that when you replace that unit, you need also new keys to your car. Okay, but then when we are planning to repair that unit, it is different story. And now I start to show you that how we inspect first the circuit board, and then maybe that how we maybe repair. There is my solder unit, tin and soldering, that how we can maybe repair that. Okay, but first thing is that I open that, and there is 6 screws, and there is my electric drill, and I take these bolts out. First one, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. Okay. And these are those standard crosshead. Actually, these are specific bolts for this computer unit, and do not install any other bolts. And there are my screws. And then when screws are open, this package opens easily, and this is cover. And there is then the circuit board, and please take your fingers in this white plastic area carefully, and then take that in here and touch this in these sides in that way. And now I take, and there is this aluminium cover, what looks like that. And then I insert that in here, and then one warning message. Please use that kind of rubber gloves, because I think that this is insulation material, and it eliminates those electric those chocks and electric impulse what can damage these electric computers. And then I recommend also that we use this anti-statistic wrist, and we insert first this metallic area in against our wrist, this skin in that way. And this system works so that when there is connection between the metallic part and my skin, this is like grounding. It ground my body's this electric currency and voltage and amperes, and then I need to insert that in some grounding position, that some metallic floor or pipe or something else, that this my electricity goes in ground. Okay. Now this my grounding is okay, and then we start to inspect this my, I take all extra dirties in here away, because they can do issues, and then we start to investigate that circuit board, that is there any issues. Okay, and I take my small screwdriver. Put this in here, and when we are planning to investigate the circuit board, we are now planning to search in there any cracks or holes or something burnouts. There has been happen some electric shock, and let's look a little bit far away, and then touch this always in the sides and sides in that way. Look, there's my, I'm touching in only in here. Not so that I am not ever touching like that way, that I touch this area and then this central area. No, it is very dangerous. And now when I look these my components in here, we can go to look that closer. that area. I looked that in here that everything, all components looks in here okay. I can't see any damage, and then I rotated my circuit board in other side, because there is also those components, and then when I look all of these through, I can't see any issues. Everything looks good. Okay, and then I remember that there is this circuit board grounding, and they are these areas, every side. There is that kind of area, and here, and also in here, and then is there also, no, there is no nothing in here, but look that side, this area. There is this interesting thing, that there is this, I take a little bit closer view, and then when we look in there, we can maybe see that there is this one, two, those metallic small these lines in here. They are grounding. And in that point, we can see that there is this material. Material is away. And I need to add in there a little bit this tin and soldering. And then when I look what other areas, there is similar. And there has been happened situation when we look in here. That this area, there are grounding joints. What purpose is that they contact in this aluminium cover. And this aluminium cover is like minus area. Because there are those connections to car ground body. And now when we look that, there has been happened so that, and I insert that carefully back, there has been happened so that these areas where this grounding is, let's look that where they are. They are, I take also my pencil. I have in here a pencil. Now it makes this color. I check that where is that first one in here. And I do in that another side, in here, I do small mark, X. And then there is, we can see this spiral thing in there. And then there was also in here, that area. There is also, and also in here. There is issue. Okay, good. And now we can think that what has been made these things, that this soldering has been like burn out in here, in this area especially. There is something hammering. Something hammering is there when we look this. Maybe we can we see anything better now? And there, this is something has hammered this area. And I need to add there this tin. And then we look that what is the reason for that? Why this has been happened? Okay, and then I take this my cover. And there is this my tin. And circuit board. And then I check that this part, it has been hit in here, that area, because this, there is that, and in here, and then that side, and they have been, they contact in these sides, and there is even some markings in here, look, there. And also in there. And now I believe that this grounding, it has been burned out. Okay, that means that now I need this soldering device, and there is power, and I insert first like this maximum power, there's power setting, and there is my soldering device, and there is this tin, what I am next using, and then I do so that when I am planning to tin these areas where is this soldering is away, that I little bit scratch. I have in here this metallic pin, and I little bit scratch those areas in here. That is my scratch purpose, is that I do in here better just skin, better connection in that way. And I add in here this more this tin. And then I take in that area. And look, this area is like a little bit bigger, those old solderings. There is this is like maybe 0.5 millimeter high, this line. And now I need to add in there this tin, and also in that area. And maybe this thing is the reason why this my system don't work. I do those scratches in here, and then there is this final part is in here, and here those things, they are totally over. And I think that maybe this soldering can help that this part takes then better contact. Okay, let's look. Okay, good. Now there is that situation. And there is this my soldering tin. And let's start. And now this is hot, and how I can see that it is hot when I test a little bit in paper. Okay, works fine, it do smoke and everything is okay. And then I am planning to tin that, and this is not so easy. I little bit burn out, heat up this first. And then I insert my tin in there. Okay. And this is not maybe the I do in here big heat. I add in there more of this. Only in that area this tin. Good. Let's look then that how this work is, how this thing is working. This soldering is interesting. And first I heat that, and then I insert the tin. Do in here some then I check that this my tin goes to all areas. Okay. Looks insert in here also. And remember that insert this tin only in this area where is this grounding, not in here. Okay, at that I think that this is quite okay. And then I replace in that corner. There is first a little bit heat up. And this my soldering device is quite professional. This cost about maybe $100. Okay. Okay, and then in here a little bit, that corner. Okay, good. Okay, this is good, and then final part. Part is this part in here. First little bit heat up. And then more steamery tin. And then do not touch with this part in any of those components, because it is bad. And remember that this soldering head is hot. Okay. More heat up. Okay. There is one. Okay, now I think that these systems, they are ready. And there is this part. This is fixed also, and then that part in here. Okay, and then if we found and or we like to solder some another components in here, in same idea in here, and then I think that I insert this my cover, and there is this my circuit board. Let's look at how it goes back. Okay, now it's back in there. Good. And then I insert that cover in here. That way. Good. And then I had these my screws. I insert this my screws in there. And then when I have fastened all of these 7 screws, I can go to install. I am planning to install that back in my car, and then I check that what is the result of my defects and how this works, and then I can report more. Okay, and here is this information, bolts back, and that kind of information that how we can inspect and repair our cars, this ECU unit. Okay, and thank you for watching, and have a nice day to you.